Hey guys, Curvin here, and welcome
into
back
the
to Hand of Fate.
Searching for the dead and dying.
We're on the second half of the journey. Only six bosses remain. The Queen of Skulls is next. Whenever the player purchases a new item, they gain a curse. So no buying of items. All traders have been persuaded to offer cheaper items. Okay, I see how this works. You're like, oh, you get a benefit, but each time you get a curse.
So much death and sorrow in the world. Can you hear the winds keening in Loth? Can you hear the dirges as the trees and the earth cry out in sorrow? This is the Queen of Skulls, and that is all she can hear. It has driven her to madness. Her touch is the promise of death, and I say to you, you were warned. Farewell.
Okay, I want to get some of this stuff in. So what don't I want? Healer's Ring, whenever the player receives healing, they gain also plus one gold. I don't really care about that. Let's drop the Healer's Ring. And let's get the Plunderer's Cap. Yeah, that's a really nice one. Ring of Poverty. We don't know what it is yet. Ring of Justice. Using a weapon ability causes the player to be fully healed with a ring and the ring to be destroyed. End of combat. It's interesting, but I think I'm going to go with the new Fool's Gold. Ernie's Helmet. Lismar take double damage from the player's attacks. Oh, shit. Okay, let's think about this. What do you do? Helm imbues the wearer with greater movement speed. Okay, greater movement speed is not a big deal for me. I think I'll take Herne's Helmet. I got some real interesting stuff. Yeah, I don't know what this does yet. Once per cap, press 2 to activate an aura that makes every single strike drop gold. Every successful strike drop gold. That's pretty good. Feathered Ice, the card is new. Okay. Spirit Walk. We become ethereal and we don't take damage, but I don't really care about that much. Let's take Mage Strike. It's a new one. I want to see what it does. Consuming Shade. All weapon attacks are enhanced with a powerful poison that taints the victim's mind and body. Drop you. Let's try Eye of the Storm. See what that's all about. I have a lot of helms, to be honest. Healing Cap, definitely I want to keep. Reveal Stair Encounters upon entering a level and grants a gold bonus for revealing every encounter on a level. I think I'm going to drop the Explorer's Helmet. And let's pick up Spiritual Healing. How many more helmets do we have? We have 4 or 5 helmets. Plunder's is really good. I'm gonna drop the Hermes one, and I'm gonna take the Occult Ring. I think we're gonna end it with this. Okay. Then here. Let's see. Treasure chests. We've done treasure chests. Marketplace can give us food. We don't need you anymore. Drop you. What is new? So we did get some new stuff. Check the town. Metal ore. It's new. I want to try it out. And let's go to Merchant's Favor. Ooh, Devil's Wager. I guess I'll drop it. It's good, but I want to try one of the new ones. Holy Forge, I guess. Charity 2, we still haven't encountered. We've done the Helpful Priest. I'll drop the Helpful Priest, and I'll take the Blood Auction. Okay. And let us try taking on the Queen of Skulls.
The lands of the Queen of Skulls are unhealthy for the living.
Oh, shit. 8? Oh, God. Okay.
Few have reached the depths of the game that you have attained. They were too weak or too inflexible, too passionate or lacking in the necessary will. You are different.
I am different. I thank you for noticing. Let's try one more time to get the freaking chest. Can I roll? I don't know. Ooh, this is not gonna be an easy one. Come on! Come on! I mean, I can just go down the mill, right? Damn it! What the hell? Oh, come on! What the hell? What? I was moving! The hitbox is way larger than... What the fuck? Okay.
It is but a game.
You watch it back
again,
yourself.
Again, you lose. I thought you would do better than this.
I was walking forward.
Can you muster the strength to go on?
When I could. And I got hit. When I wasn't actually being hit. I called BS. I called BS on this.
Come now. The queen awaits.
Oh, start. Yeah, I said start. Ah, goddamn. Okay, one more time. Freaking 8.
What brings you to play the game?
It's
I
fun.
Know you will not tell me. Like all the rest, you are
Dark
silent.
Dweller. Your path is blocked
Even
by an evil mass of tentacles and eyes.
From.
Even as you watch, a thing spouts new limbs, reaching eagerly for you. Attempt to get around the creature. Yeah, of course. Gonna get caught, gonna get hit, gonna get...
Select your desire.
Yeah. Your long will last only so long before the tentacles get hold of you. The lure draws you 2 main cards. 30% max health.
Oh, dear.
Oh. Sorry. 30% max health. I feel this is a lot of health. Give me some food. 3.
I'm sure you are grateful for that.
8. Okay. 8 food's great. Noble trader.
Wealth
again.
Separates the highest from the lowest. And that is, in itself, a form of virtue.
There you go, Demon Trader 2. You spend a restless night with your dreams haunted by visions of a strange demon's sniff and says. They say you visit the altar, yet you have no mark of the gods upon you. Be gone. In the morning you feel drained. Oh, great. So I know where the warlord is? Okay. Let's continue on. Whatever.
I did not create this game, you know.
Oh, God,
I have
Dark
merely Dwell. Perfected it. You have begun to understand my innovations. Evil made flesh, but with no craft or substance. Powerful magic, but unfocused.
Yeah, this is BS. Oh, look, a shop.
Of course.
Oh, nice.
So few trade in the land of death that deals are easy to strike.
I mean, 51 health is still, like, okay. So everything's cheaper, right? Like, how much cheaper? 18, 12. Three for shield. Does fire damage on hits against undead? Oh, we're playing against undead. I gotta give me my curse. Yes,
what
equip.
What would you do with that?
Last man standing. That's fine. I'm gonna, not starve. Or not get screwed by enemies, hopefully. Okay. Here we go. Ratmen. Lovely. 6, 4. Let's take on the Ratmen. My ability does nothing against, Ratmen. It's purely against, which we call undead. Which is fine. But I really should just start attacking. And just countering when needed. No. Okay, it's looking good. Oh, double counter? I don't know. Good. Okay, come here so I don't take too much damage. Holy shit, I did that without taking a single hit. That is incredible to me. How I managed to do that is beyond me, but I will take it and I will be happy. Oh. Okay.
I hear nothing but the sounds of mourning. She is close. A permanent discount for those willing to endure the local color.
Dark ritual.
The more powerful the site, the more vile its trespasses.
While searching the sacred tomes of Wandermere, you come across a group of skeletons conducting a dark ritual. The dealer draws you 3 monster
Jack
cards.
Jack of Skulls returns to the fray. Would you expect any less?
Okay. So, I mean, we have something that literally makes them go on fire. Like, that is awesome. Okay. Let's do it again. Look at that. Look at them burn. I hope they're taking, like, dot damage. Because otherwise this is not worth it. But... and... Ooh, did I just get countered? Look at them burn. This is great. I love this. Oh. This thing's so good. Look at them fall. Hey. No reviving your men, Jack. Okay. Okay, Jack. I can't stop him either. It's fine. It should be fine. Hopefully, in a moment, they'll all be dead. Yep, okay. I have sustained a little bit of damage here, but... Undead Bane is fantastic. Fan-freaking-tastic. Dryer 2, equipment cards. Card stuff is yours. Fleet Coast
faster
increases the risk.
Is always better.
One
piece
bang.
Of each type of equipment, and you're ready to take on the world.
No, I'm not gonna take it. Staying inside a moment later, you hear an holy shriek that will haunt your dreams forever.
Wow.
Let's just continue around. Okay.
Again, a token is at stake.
Let's try it again. Hopefully, I'm not gonna get screwed this time. With the traps. But you never know. I mean, again. Careful. Okay. Just come back down. Okay. Good. Oh, there's a chest. There's a chest. I presume that means I took it. Was there always a crate there? Did I just always miss it? Okay. Fire, go away. Okay, good. Nah. Doesn't matter. We made it. We're alive. That's the main thing. Oh, we're very much hurt, but we're alive. Good work, Miss Lionel explains, seeing the loot you return with. You see, I told you there was more to be gained from one of these vaults. You divide up the treasure between the two of you. Vio draws you 3 game cards. Draw 2, select 1 to keep. Ooh, feathered ice. Green Collar, press 2 to create a blast of freezing ice centered on the adventurer. Sure. Draw 3, select 1 to keep. Ooh, what's this? Whenever the player is healed,
if you're strong of spirit, you'll find this a boon. If not, well.
Cold. Nearby enemies are immediately slowed as the...
This armor pulls energy from the world around you.
I'm gonna do the armor of cold to slow things down.
Are you sure that's the right approach?
I mean, whether or not I'm sure is just gonna be... We'll see, but... I hope so. A few more raids like this, and I'll be living like a king myself. Miss Lion grinds happily as he stuffs his new treasures into a pair of old sacks, then heads back into the desert. Gain the token. Holy Forge.
A brotherhood of peace in the service of war. Never trust a priest.
On a dusty, lonely plain, you come across the shattered remains of an old monastery. Searching the building, you meet an old man dressed in dirty robes. Long ago, we of the Brotherhood forged holy weapons to support the war against the infidels. But the infidels were strong, and one day, one of their raiding parties took us by surprise. They destroyed most of our tools and took our supplies, including all the rare metal ore that we used to craft our weapons. The king's army never returned after that day. I know not what became of them in the years that followed. I have stayed here all these years, but only the ghosts remain to keep me company. All of the others who survived the attack left long ago. You bid the monk farewell and leave him standing in the silent, empty ruin. Okay, so I guess I need probably some ore or something.
I am not surprised they have difficulty selling their wares here.
I mean, depends. Can they heal? If they can heal, I mean, they're gonna get some money. Yep, they can heal.
If you gain health, then I work harder to take it.
That's fine. You can work harder. I'll go ahead and buy that as well. Just max out on health. And I'll buy some food. 18 gold for that. Jeez. And you know what? Take it. There we go. Cool. We're good. I think they're on this floor, so I'm pretty sure it's coming up. A metal ore.
Sparse and relatively empty.
As you traverse a particularly tricky trail across a mountain ridge, you notice a dark ravine beneath you. Something glitters in the dim sunlight that reaches the base of the cavern. Come down, take a look. In the gloom of a narrow canyon, you find old remains of a wooden cart, apparently having fallen down years ago. You find nothing of worth except a chunk of a glittering metallic ore. It might not sell for much in its currency, but perhaps you can find someone who can use it. You take it and make your way back up the path. This one's still lit up. I presume I can go back to it. I have a decent amount of food. Pass it by. Can I? Holy Forge.
A ruined monastery. So sad.
Give the monk a sample of your ore. The monk's eyes widen in surprise as he explains, "By the old gods, where did you find that?" He looks the metal over carefully. "If you're willing to put in the hard work, stranger, together we could fire up the old forge one last time." Spent several days with the old monk. By day, you toil together at the forge, and by night, you swap tales of your adventures for a share of his food. Eventually, you hold the completed weapon in your hands. Battle Hammer, 40 damage. Stirring together a consecutive attack to do massive damage, plus one to each powerful explosion. I'm not gonna equip it. It's great. It's great. Thank you, warrior. You're welcome. Let us continue on. Pass it by. This way. Blood auction.
Moonlight, unholy creatures.
In the moonlit ruins of the long forgotten castle.
Once, but I hope it is the last time.
A host of unholy creatures gather together. You discover that the vampires are holding sacred blood auctions. Mortals are allowed to bid their own blood. Bid some blood. Sorry, you don't have enough blood left to make the minimum bid. Heal up and come back later. Damn. Local peasant.
Feast, famine, and everything in between.
While crossing a forest clearing, you meet a peasant woman. "Being a stranger, the winter has been hard on my family this year, and the forest behind her, you sense movement. Give a woman two food." The woman takes your food eagerly, passing it to the children, who suddenly rush to the forest, hands up. While the children eat, the woman speaks at length of what she has seen and heard recently. Okay, so it is going to where I thought it was going. Cool. The marketplace.
"Not a good day to be in Stiegel. So few are."
Bid half my gold. I mean, at this point, even one food's good, but... Success! One food gain card. Buy food. Okay. Let's do it. Queen of Skulls. Powerful skeleton warrior.
Learn your fate.
With ability to summon a demonic pile of skulls that can create a legion of skeletons.
As you
plunder
the secrets of your memories, you'll gain new cards. Some you'll wish you'd left untouched.
That's fine. We got this. So she can summon things that summon other things, basically. How lovely. It's okay. We got the ultimate. Oh, shit. She's got a rifle. That's not cool. Oh, I see. I need to take down that thing. Okay, you take this thing down. Ah! Okay. Burn, guys, burn. She also burns. Great, great. If I run around and dodge her a little bit, I can do this quite a bit, right? And do a lot of damage to her. It's at 4. I have a feeling I have a limited amount of use of this. Yeah, 2. Is that how many I hit? Wait, is that it? Oh. Doesn't matter. Oh, your curse was your own demise, really. thanks to that curse and the ability for me
then
to gain.
Done. When even a creature as haunting as the Queen of Skulls perishes, we know the game is almost done. The kings are gathering now. Do you see now what I have built? How elegantly all the pieces fit.
Oh, that weapon is real good against skeletons. Holy shit. When drafting the Dark Ritual, you receive the following card. The Lich. We're helping Mr. Lionel with his quest to receive the Goblin King's Halls 4. For working in the Holy Forge, you receive draw 3, select 1 to keep, and Forbidden Armor. Ooh. As a reward for defeating my Skeleton Queen, I receive the Queen of Plague and the Lizard Dome. And Arrow Cutter and Mortal Whimsy. Not too many cards.
One more round. You have earned it.
But damn it, you did it. Yes. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.